different artificial intelligence agents will compete to become the best sandcastle builders in the entire world. They will have to learn prioritize between taking care of their own castle, destroying neighboring castles, or chilling, lol. Meet Pogo, Chickles, and Greg. You might know these three friends from previous videos, where they used to have lots of fun together. Well, they finally deserved a vacation, and they thought, what better vacation than a never-ending cycle of agony where you must build the same castle over and over under scorching heat while constantly being bullied by two other dum-dums. Am I right? Well, let me quickly explain how this simulation works. We have three AI agents, and each of them has a sandcastle that is designed to best fit their character. Our little Chickles has an intricate dragon statue displaying his creativity and artisan skills, despite the IQ level that can be counted on your fingers. Very impressive! Greg, on the other hand, being the pragmatic soldier that he is, made this sniper tower with meticulous attention to details. Remarkable work. And then there is Pogo with this monolithic structure? Yeah, he's always been a special one. The agents are able to move in any direction, but they can also rotate left and right, giving them a full range of motion to navigate through the environment. If the AI is near enough to the sea, he will be able to fill up his water bucket. If a full bucket is brought to an enemy castle, it can be spilled onto the building, dealing some damage. If you can have a nice castle, nobody should. A damaged castle can be repaired by its owner, which will prove essential for winning the competition. Agents will get score points based on how much health their castle has. A fully repaired castle will give the agents 1 score point per second. One that is half repaired will result in 0.5 score points per second, and a completely destroyed castle won't give any points to its owner. That's why finding a balance between keeping your castle repaired and destroying others' hard work will prove crucial to win. Moreover, as you could notice, there is a comfy sun lounger on the beach as well. An agent can relax on the lounger for as long as he wants, and that will multiply the score it gets. Unlike you, the AI can stop procrastinating whenever he wants and get back to work. That will also stop the score multiplication, duh. I'm not sure if any of the agents will end up using the lounger in their strategy, but it does add another layer of fun in the simulation. Talking about strategies, each one of these lab rats has a unique feature that will ensure they come up with different methods to win the game. For example, Chickles has twice the move speed compared to others, making him the most agile of the three. Greg, being the giga chad that he is, deals 50 damage to enemy castles compared to 25 damage that others do. Pogo really loves his rock, so his ability is to heal his own castle twice as fast, ensuring his precious block is not destroyed. In order to prevent these dum-dums from blindly stumbling around and smacking into obstacles, all agents will shoot a set number of lasers called ray casts that basically serve as their eyes. Very shitty eyes. Luckily, they seem content, and even if they were not, I didn't implement any ways for them to tell me, so we're fine. Once such a ray collides with an obstacle, like a sandcastle, it will return the object's information, such as the type and distance to that object, allowing our dum-dums to see how dire their situation actually is. The agents will also have access to information such as the status of their bucket, full or not, their castle's current health points, their current score, whether or not anyone is currently using the sound lounger, and the actions they are currently performing. Based on all of these observations, the agents will choose the actions they deem to be the most fitting, which will then result in either a punishment or a reward. Punishing the agent for all of his mistakes and losses will not only leave a lifelong trauma on our lab rat, but also teach him important life lessons such as death is not the solution. Literally. The round simply resets and the fun continues, lol. As a result, the AI will try to focus on those actions that maximize the reward and minimize the punishment received. First few rounds, the AI kept running aimlessly in random directions, trying to figure out what purpose they serve. Ah, poor guys. If only they knew that the point of their whole existence is simply our entertainment. But in just few iterations, Pogo and Greg figured out the castles can be repaired, and spent the entire round touching their towers.
In a Naughty.
Few more confused attempts later, and Chickles also joined the boys and began mending to his sandcastle. Dozens of rounds passed until anything meaningful happened, and that is considering I have been training 20 simulations in parallel, each with their own Pogo, Greg and Chickles. But eventually, on iteration 117, Greg finally figured out he can chill on the lounger, gaining multiplied score points. Hit the like and subscribe button if that's also how you use the sun lounger. Jokes aside, there is a good reason why I haven't implemented any animations for the AI whenever they're using the lounger. I'm lazy. I mean, this whole thing isn't even real. Well, duh, it's a virtual simulation, you might say, smartass. But I mean the training of the AI is not real. It was mainly a proof of concept for me to make sure that this idea is even feasible. As a matter of fact, most of it happened on stream here on YouTube as well as on my Twitch channel, where I stream every Monday, Wednesday and Friday. Besides working on projects, we often play games there, so make sure to hop on sometime. But enough with the shameless self-plug, let's see how the real training was, which by the way lasted an entire week, and there's a lot to unpack. First few hundred rounds were full of AI confusion, sweat, tears, agony and misery. All the necessary things to ensure a good time. But after a good night's sleep, I woke up to see the agents that aren't only focused on their own castles, but also are able to find the time to care about others. And by care I mean spend the entire round to gather water in attempts to destroy Greg's tower, while your own tower is barely standing. Now that's what I call dedication. As you can see, Greg is currently by far the best at this game, having more than 1400 wins, while Chickles has only 162 wins, and Pogo sits at 383, but that is soon to change drastically. I don't know for sure what happened around iteration 2200, but it is best understood when you look at the training graph. Here, Chickles is the gray line, Pogo is the orange line, and Greg is the blue one. And as you can see, Greg was dominating by a huge margin when suddenly it all took a different turn and Pogo took the lead, rising above Greg. This can also be seen by the numerous wins Pogo started scoring, which, while impressive at first, turned out disappointing soon enough. You see, as much as I want to believe that it was due to Pogo coming up with a masterful strategy, the reality is that Greg simply got depressed from being harassed and bullied by Chickles and started aimlessly wandering around the map. This, together with the fact that the other idiot was more focused on destruction rather than keeping his own castle full, resulted in Pogo, who was only focused on healing his tower, taking the lead. Luckily, that was just a phase, and after some time, Greg once again began protecting his property from the little bully. By the way, talking about little bullies, I have been visiting a friend of mine in Belgium, and he has two of the cutest bunnies I have ever seen. They were cute and soft and very playful, so overall it was great, but for some reason they really disliked my pants, lol. They eventually managed to make a hole in them, but then again, I got to cuddle those cute bastards, so no regrets. In the meantime, my agents kept training all this time while I was gone, and after 10,000 iterations and more than 200 hours of training, here is the final result. Oh, by the way, in case you were wondering what is behind the camera, let me show you. These are the legendary Patreon penguins. Thanks for supporting the channel. Your help means I get to eat, and I like eating. Thank you, and now let's get back to the final results. Seems like I forgot to turn off the random starting health for the castles, and Greg got the worst one, lol. He rushes to repair it and does a pretty good job, but then Chickles suddenly gets triggered and after attacking Pogo's castle once, goes straight for Greg. Chickles kept being annoying while Greg desperately tried to repair all the destruction this little dum-dum was causing. Once he realized it makes no sense, Chickles decided to switch his target to Pogo, and honestly, that is to be expected. After all, Chickles has the highest mobility, and that actually seems to be the best use for that skill. What does surprise me is Greg, who is a little over-focused on his castle considering his huge damage. Pogo did not appreciate his tower being damaged and immediately quit his peaceful stroll and started attacking the sand dragon in an act of revenge. He then proceeds mending to his building and Chickles, who seems to have realized the mathematical meaning of this graph, seeing his castle being attacked, started repairing it as well, lol. But here is the weird thing. Despite Greg spending almost the entire round with a fully built castle, he did not get the highest number of points in the end. I could not figure out what the issue was, since more HP should mean more score points, but after a thorough investigation, it all started to make sense. It might be hard to believe it, but I actually made a dumb mistake. I know, I told you it's hard to believe it. But I'll try to explain what the issue was in just 30 seconds. Normalizing a value means adjusting it to a standard scale, typically between 0 and 1, so that it can be compared or combined with other values more easily. It enhances the AI training and is usually done by dividing your value by the maximum possible value. That is what I tried doing, but instead of using castle maximum health, I used the start health, which meant that the lower the starting health is, the higher the reward will be. Since that formula was used both for the score and for the reward function, it meant all the training got fucked up and I just lost several hundreds of hours of progress. Whew. Cool, right? Well, I fixed the issue and started training all over from scratch, but I'm not gonna bore you with another training footage, so after about 50 more hours of training, here is the final result. It all started with Chickles and Greg bullying Pogo and attempting to destroy his castle. Pogo's ability of repairing the castle twice as fast proves crucial, and after quickly rebuilding the castle, while Chickles was focused on Greg's tower, Pogo even managed to chill on the sun lounger for a bit, gaining multiplied score points. The other two once again grouped against Pogo, and after spilling two buckets of water each, they destroyed the castle and forced Pogo to end his vacation and start repairing. It's funny how Chickles, despite having his own castle broken, is more focused on being a nuisance for the others, lol. Despite Chickles and Greg's attempts to cause damage, Pogo is not letting his gorgeous sand cube fall, maintaining it at full HP. Chickles has finally remembered that he also has a castle to worry about and started healing it for a bit before going back into destruction mode. The time is slowly running out, and it seems that the offensive strategy is not as efficient if you target the guy who can repair twice as fast. But despite that, these dum-dums demonstrate great dedication. Anyways, looks like Pogo won, and by a huge margin. That's it for this video, but while you wait for my lazy ass to release the next one, you might check out this other video I made where I have AI gladiators with different skills and abilities fight each other. Bye!